Hey guys, and welcome to a brand new video. So today, in my opinion, is pretty exciting because we're celebrating Star Stable's 7th birthday. I believe Star Stable's anniversary is either on the 4th or the 5th of October. Please correct me if I'm wrong. I just really want to get my facts straight, but I can't search it up right now because my internet's not working properly. So I'm sorry about that. So the website says that we have a party on Jorvik right now, which is in Moreland, where the Midsummer Festival was too. We have, just like last year, the birthday races. We have to find golden horseshoes, which I really liked last year, to be honest, and we have a gift. And do you know what this gift is? Well, you probably read it by the title, but this year's gift is actually a flying bird. It's a flying pet. It's so exciting. I really can't wait to see it. So without any further ado, let's jump straight into this update. My goodness, you guys, I just arrived in Moreland, and can I just say that I love the colors of the birthday party this year. I really love these colors. It really gives me autumn vibes. I really love it. Okay, quick side note, I'm not gonna be running a lot in this video because my internet is actually horrible. I'm so sorry if you experience lag. I really can't help it. Anyways, I quickly want to point out that this area is also open to non-star riders, so also the non-star riders can participate in this event. So that means you can also celebrate Star Stable's 7th birthday even if you're not a star rider. So basically what you can do here at the party is fire some fireworks, you can dance, you can eat some cake, etc. But that's not the only thing, because we also have birthday races, which I'll get to in a minute, but we also have the collecting golden horseshoes thing, which we also had last year. And to start that, you have to talk to this woman over here. Star Stable turns 1 year older. Time for a celebration. How about a treasure hunt? Golden horseshoes have been placed all over Jorvik for you to collect. You can trade 5 golden horseshoes for a gift. There's a lot of gifts, so just keep looking. Believe me, you'll definitely want these gifts. I would. The golden horseshoes can be found in and around Moreland, Silverglade, Fort Pinta, Valedale, and Fairgrove. If you can't find any more in one area, then look in the next. I've hidden so many golden horseshoes that there's more than enough. Okay, so you need 5 golden horseshoes in order to trade them in for an item. And just a quick side note, there's 8 birthday items, which includes clothing and equipment, of course. And I'm so excited for this year's outfit because it just has autumn colors, and I'm a huge autumn fan, so without any further ado, let's just collect a few items, and I'll be right back. Okay, you guys, so I found 20 of these golden horseshoes, so now let's return back to the party and exchange these for items. I'm really excited to see what this outfit is like, so yeah, let's go. Also, I just want to say I'm totally not obsessed with this horse. Okay, I am, I'll admit it, but, you know, I just really can't dismount this horse. I'm sorry for using it twice in, like, 2 videos, but I just can't. I really love this horse. Okay, you guys, so here we are, and now let's exchange these horseshoes and see what we'll get. Okay, you guys, so let's have a look. So first I got this bridle, which I kind of like, to be honest. Then we got this sweater, which, oh my god, it's so cute. I really like this. And look at the 7 on the back, that's so cute. Yes, this is definitely my favorite so far, even though this is like the 2nd item. But here we have the saddle pad, which also is really pretty. Oh my gosh, the cap, which makes me feel like a Star Stable employee, but I'm not really mad about that, you guys. And we don't have any other golden horseshoes, so I'm gonna ride to Fort Pinta right now because the first birthday race is right over there. You can check in on your log quest. You can check on your quest log where the birthday race is for that specific day, and the birthday race today is in Fort Pinta, so let's go. The reason why I'm so excited for these birthday races is not because they're like a new race or something. They're just these regular races. For example, this is the normal Fort Pinta track, but the thing is, these races give you 1,500 horse XP. You heard me right, 1,500 horse XP, which is so insane. It's just very convenient because, you know, I'm not really a training person. I think all of you know that by now. I keep telling you guys, but it's true. And the thing is, when you do these races, you can also spot some horseshoes that you haven't picked up yet. So far, I've spotted 4 already, which is great, honestly. While I am doing this race, I quickly want to point out that the birthday celebrations will stay until October 17th, which is for 2 weeks, I'm pretty sure. So honestly, do those birthday races, they're so worth it. My only dislike about these races is you have one on Wednesday, Thursday, on Friday, on Saturday, on Sunday, etc., but you can only do them once on that certain day. So if you have done them today, Wednesday, you can't do them next Wednesday. after, like, you can only do one in one place once, which is kind of sad to be honest, but let's see how much we, you know, get further into our level thingy. I don't know how to say that, I'm sorry. Let's just look at our XP bar. It was at the very beginning of level 10, and right now it's in the middle of level 10. That's just so crazy. I'm so happy, you guys. Before we are going to check out this shop over here, I quickly want to point out that today's birthday raise was obviously for Pinta. Tomorrow is Steve's Farm. Friday is Moorland. Saturday, Yorvik Stables. Sunday, Silverglade Vineyard. Monday, Vale Day Lake. And Tuesday, obviously, Fairgrove. And also, before I forget to mention, these birthday races also give you golden horseshoes. Anyway, in this shop, there's basically only food for your horse and some fireworks. So just in case you wanted to know that, there's just food and fireworks, no items, nothing special. I mean, is there any other shop to do with birthday celebrations? I don't really know. I really wish we could buy some extra items, but sadly, I don't think we can, you guys. If you are that one person that just wants to play SSO in all peace and quiet and just enjoy the experience, this new feature that they released today is 100% for you. Star Stable says, today we're releasing some new options under the creative tab in the game alternatives, which allow you to temporarily block friend requests, block group requests, and club invites. You can also temporarily shut off the blinking chat icon in the lower left corner of your screen, which I find really triggering, so I'm super happy about that. You can temporarily hide all the names of the other players in the game, which you could do with F1 before, but now you can also do it with this option in your options menu. And you can also temporarily hide all the location names that pop up on your screen whenever you enter a new area, and I love this because I love making music videos too, and MEP parts, MEP parts, however you want to call it, and I really feel like this is going to help me so much. Sometimes those location names are a real struggle, so for all those editors out there, this is such a great update. Also, quick side note, all of these options are reset whenever you log out of the game. Now, you are probably also wondering if you want to use these features, how to use them. Well, all you need to do is just click on your settings right over here, or click on the escape button, click on options, and go to creative, and right over here you see all these show slash hide options. Also, you guys, the hide user interface option was gone for a little while, but Star Stable finally added it back, so here you go, the hide user interface is finally back. Now let's get to the really exciting part of this update, because there is a new code that will give you a flying bird, which I'm so excited about this. The code is freegull, which will give you a seagull in your mailbox over here. I'm gonna enter the code in my app right now and I'll be right back. I just realized you can't redeem a code in the Star Stable friends app, so I'm gonna do it in my Safari app for a second, starstable.com, and I'll be right back. Here we are, you guys, we have a gift for you mail from Star Stable. Oh my god, that's so cute, the birthday bird. I like that. Okay, let's do I have a saddlebag? Yes, I do. Okay, so let's put this bird in our saddlebag. Oh, look at that. Let's let it loose and let it fly. Oh my god, look. You guys, we finally have a flying bird. I know you guys have been wanting this, and I'm so happy. This is great. If we take a closer look to this bird, it has some birthday stuff on it too. It has like a little hat and then around its neck. I don't really know the names of these things, so I'm sorry, but the bird is so detailed. I like it. I kind of want to see what it looks like when I'm running, so let's just go ahead and run. Oh my god, look at that, you guys. Look at that. That's so cool. Okay, now let's dismount. I first have to put my horse, like, not in the middle of the way. Let's dismount over here and see what it looks like when I'm just on foot. I hope it's gonna follow me still. And will it? Yes, it will. Okay, there it is. Oh, that's so amazing. I love that. Anyways, that was basically it for today, you guys. I really like this update. I've always been a fan of the birthday celebrations, and again, this year, I really like it. A quick reminder at the end of this video will be that the Yorvik City Fashion Week will stay for another week, the Coulters will leave next week too, and the horse market is currently open for business at Steve's Farm. I want to ask you guys to leave a comment down below congratulating Star Stable on their 7th birthday, because I really think they did such amazing work in the past 7 years. Of course, for me too, congratulations, Star Stable. I think you've done such amazing work in the past 7 years, and I really am excited for what's about to come. So yeah, that was my speech. Thank you for listening. I'm joking, of course. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, let me know by liking this video. I would really, really appreciate that. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel to never miss out on any videos. You can also turn on your notifications so you'll never ever miss out. And yeah, I really hope I'll see you on Saturday with a brand new video. Bye, guys!